God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and he'll be there. Welcome back to Exotic Astrology again. And if you're new to the channel and you have not still subscribed yet, then I don't know what to say. Please subscribe. And if you want a personal consultation with me, then the link to my new website, Vedic Renaissance, is there below. Check it out and mail me accordingly. And if you like this video, after watching till the end, then click the thumbs up. All right. So what is today's topic? Today's topic is Jupiter and Mercury. What's the difference between the two? Every time we use these planets and their significations, the karak tattvas, interchangeably, we say that both are significators of education. That is true. But what kind of education? You will say, no, Mercury is material, Jupiter is spiritual. Well, is it true? Or is it not true? Or if it is true, to what extent is it true? That is the question. Or is there a different angle to it? Can Mercury also have a spiritual angle to it? Or can Jupiter also have a mundane aspect? We will see that today in this video. What is the difference between information, knowledge, and wisdom? Information means gathering data, reading a book, for example. You are reading, there are 10 chapters in the book. Suppose you are reading the Bible. I don't know how many chapters are there, but how many ever. And then you read it. So when you are reading it, you are understanding what the author is trying to say. Any book, maybe Harry Potter. And then you are able to read between the lines. That is Mercury. You are basically having a grasp of what the person is trying to speak to you. What is he trying to convey to you? Yes, that is the difference between information and knowledge. Information means, okay, this person did this, this person did that, but then at the end, he did this. So what? So then you understand, it's like a painting. You draw it from here, there, here, there, here, there, here, there. It reached there. So you know how the flow is happening. All these things come under Mercury. All the ability to grasp knowledge. That is why you see some people, they need long time to grasp things. Some people need very less time to grasp things. But the question is, what after the knowledge? That is the question we have to ask, right? So Jupiter will tell you, what is wisdom? Now, what is wisdom? Knowledge means what actually the author is trying to tell you. That is knowledge. But wisdom means, how can I use that knowledge in my life in a way that will benefit me and others? That is why it is the highest form of acquisition. There is no other acquisition which you can have in this life better than Jupiter. Because, for example, if you read a book like Harry Potter, I'm just giving an example because that's a famous book. You read it and you understand it. You know the stories, this happened, that happened. I've never read Harry Potter, but I'm just giving an example. You understand everything. But then the question is, does it give you wisdom? Does it help you to go close to God? Answer that question. I'm not talking of Harry Potter here. You take any example. You can read a book on political science or a book on cooking, culinary experiences, or a book on travel. But the question is it helping you to go close to God? That Jupiter will tell you that. Well, yes, it can help you. For example, if you are reading a book which says, travel from here, travel from there, travel from this place to that place. And then you find that there is a holy place nearby. And then what happens is, you go and search where that holy place is. And then you go and visit that place. When you go in that tour, that is called wisdom. Vigyan is the knowledge of what this is, what that is. But Gyan is Gya means Gyata. The word Gyan comes from the word Gya. Gya means Gyata. That means Gyata means who has given you what? That is God. So that is why Vigyan is science, materialistic knowledge, information. And Gyan is Jupiter. And the significator of knowledge is actually Mercury. Because Mercury is the grasping power, and the significator of wisdom, that is Jupiter. Now, that can also play on a mundane realm or on a spiritual realm. For example, if somebody wants to have a good grasp of the scriptures, then both Jupiter and Mercury has to be strong. Jupiter has to be stronger than Mercury. I will tell you why. Because even if Mercury is not very strong, suppose you cannot remember slokas. You don't need to remember slokas. I am saying if you know how to connect things, for example. Let me give you an example. There are different places where different things are mentioned in the same context. So you have to know how to connect them. Like in the Srimad Bhagavatam, there is a sloka which says, Akama sarva kamo va moksha kama udaradhi tivrena bhakti yogena yajeta purusham param. So there is a shloka which says, Akama sarva kamo va, which means akama, sarva kama. Kama and akama means spiritual desire, and kama means materialistic desire. Akama sarva kamova means if you have material or spiritual desire. Moksha kama udarati means all the desire of liberation, perfecting your life and going back to the spiritual world. Tivrena bhakti yogena yajeta purusham param, or you desire to develop love for God, which is bhakti yoga, which Lord Krishna talks about in the Bhagavad Gita as the supreme form of yoga. Either of this, yajeta purusham param, you should only go to the param purush. And this is said in reference to Lord Vishnu here. Alright. So now you see, in the Srimad Bhagavatam there is this shloka, that even if you want material benedictions, you should only go to Lord Vishnu and ask. Purusham Param, Yajeta Purusham Param means, it is a reference to Vishnu there. So now, one person whose Mercury is very strong, he will be finding out similar verses in the other scriptures also. For example, he may find a verse in the Bhagavad Gita where Lord Krishna says, Prapadyante Anya Devata, that verse is there. That is a similar verse which has the context, the meaning of the context is the same, although that is in a different domain Krishna is telling. There Krishna says that do not run after materialistic desires, in a sense. But there in Bhagavatam Krishna is telling, I mean Krishna is not telling, it is said about Lord Vishnu that even if you have material desires, akama sarva kamava, or any desire you have, only go to him. Then you may go to the Ramayana and find some other shloka like this. Let me give you another example. There's a shloka in the Bhagavad Gita which says, Kaunteya pratijani hi name bhaktiya pranashyati, where Lord Krishna says that Kaunteya pratijani means, O Arjuna, you declare to the world, कौन्तेया प्रतिजानीहि नमे भक्त्या प्रणश्यति मीन्स नमे भक्त्या प्रणश्यति मीन्स वन हु फॉलोज मी डज व्हाट आई से ही विल नेवर पेरिश. नमे भक्त्या प्रणश्यति उसका कभी क्षति नहीं होगा. ही विल नेवर गो इन टू लॉस. दैट मीन्स कृष्णा इज एश्योरिंग यू अ प्रोटेक्शन देयर. सो दैट इज वन श्लोका इन द भगवद गीता. ऑल राइट. Similarly, there is another shloka in, this is Narasimha Puran, I guess. In Narasimha Puran, Lord Narasimhadev says to Mother Lakshmi that if somebody has dedicated their entire life to me and at the end of their life, even if they cannot remember me, then I will go and give them my remembrance. Because Krishna says in the Gita that whatever state of being one remembers at the end of his life, that state he shall attain without fail. And in that Krishna also says in another verse, yad gatva nani vartante tad dhama paramam mama. Yad gatva nani vartante tad dhama paramam mama. If you go to the param dham, that is Vaikunth, where Lord Vishnu resides. Yad gatva na nivartante tad dhama parama mama. You do not return. That means once you go there, you don't return back. So you see, these are similar shlokas which are there. So now, a person whose mercury is very strong, he will be able to connect things. Okay, here is this, here is that, here is that. He will be very strong, very fast in connecting things. But then if Jupiter is weak, then what will happen? He will not be able to make a sense out of it, how to use it in his life. For example, if you go to my website, Vedic Renaissance, there you will see in the first page, there's a shloka. Tatenu kampam susmikshamano bhunjana eva atmakritam pipakam ridvagvapu bhir vidadham namaste jive tayo mukti pade sadaya bhak. This shloka is there. Who is quoting this shloka? This shloka Lord Brahma is quoting. In that, Lord Brahma basically he says, to summarize this shloka, that one who accepts everything that happens in his life as a result of his own karma, and he humbly bows down to you and says thank you. Because you are cleaning away my karma, oh God. That person, for him, liberation is his rightful claim. That means you can go and claim to God, oh God, please liberate me, if you do this. So if a person's Jupiter is not strong, then he will not be able to understand how to use it in my life. So how to use this verse? This verse, tate anukampam susumikshamano bhunjan evatmakritam pipakam vidvag vapu bhir vidadham namaste jive tayo mukti pade sadaiva. So how to use this? Suppose you are in a relationship. Relationship again. Then suppose your girlfriend, she cheats on you. Suppose I am saying. I hope she doesn't. But suppose she cheats on you. Then what will you do? Then will you go and blast God? Oh my God, what did you do? Why did you do like that? No. You go and pray and you say, thank you. Thank you that you gave me this. Go and call that girl and say thank you. Oh my God, how can we do that? It's impossible. It's easier said than done, right? I'm not saying it's easy. I am not at all saying it's easy. It's the most difficult thing. That is why Brahma is telling, if somebody can do this, he can claim God that, I please liberate me. Brahma is telling, liberation is his rightful claim. Because in other verses in the scriptures, it is also said, spiritual elevation is not obtained, it is awarded. Should I repeat? Spiritual elevation is not obtained, it is awarded. which means you cannot demand God that elevate me spiritually. You cannot do that. You may do, but he may not give you. That means you cannot pull it from him. He has to award you that. Award means that which flows from the up. If he wishes not to give you, you cannot do anything. He may make you Indra, the king of the heavens. But if he doesn't decide to give you spiritual elevation means if he doesn't give you sufficient reasons to be attracted to him, then you will never be attracted to him. So that's what I am saying. This is a very difficult thing. But a person who has a strong Jupiter, he will know how to use these things in life. Probably if he has a breakup, he will go and say thank you. Not immediately, after some time. I mean that will never happen. I am speaking of an imaginary scenario here, depending on the other situations of the horoscope and depending on his spiritual level. Depending on so many other factors, I am saying that will happen. But if a person whose Mercury is only strong, he will be just reading slokas, okay, in this book there is this, in this book there is that. And he will understand also, but he cannot apply. The difference between Jupiter and Mercury is, Jupiter can give you the power to apply that in your life. Because Jupiter is faith. To apply something, you need faith. That is the fundamental difference. There is nothing of faith in Mercury. Mercury has no connection with faith. But Jupiter is faith. If you do not believe, you do not have faith in that shloka, you cannot do it. That is the difference between Jupiter and Mercury. You see? I see. Everybody sees it right now. Alright, that is it from my side. If you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up and check out my new website, Vedic Renaissance. And if you want a consultation from me, then let me know. So there you go. This was the difference between Jupiter and Mercury. To summarize, Mercury is knowing things, and Jupiter, how should I apply it in my life? And when you can apply? When there is faith. Alright, that is it from my side. I hope that God gives you the wisdom to understand how to apply these scriptural principles in our life. Okay, until next time, wish you good luck. Bye bye. See you.